First off, I just want to thank everyone for being here tonight. For those of you that know me, I've been coaching for a little bit here, but this is the most important game on the schedule for us, so thank you for being here. I also want to say a huge thank you to Armbrae for coming up for this game. I've known John for a long time, and it's just nice that we get to coach against each other, so give Armbrae a round of applause and thank you. Before I get into honoring tonight's seniors, I just want to give a little special shout out to a special group that made a point to be here. We have a saying that we play for our seniors and our seniors play for our alumni, and there's some alumni that are here tonight. I'd like to say welcome to Owen Microwave Smith, class of 23, Ben Big Ticket Power, class of 23, Jack Moose Whitefield, class of 20, Calvin Franz Keller, class of 16, and Jack the Example Smith, class of 2015, so thank you to you guys for being here. And Zachary Ducky Duel, getting texted that he is going to be here tonight, class of 2015. Always say the best for last, Ducky. So we have three seniors tonight that we'll be recognizing. The first one goes by the name of Berger, the Iceman. Urban. Berger's originally from Iceland, hence the name the Iceman. And I think it was always kind of in the plan that Berger was going to attend RNS for high school. But what wasn't in that plan was playing for this team. Berger had to work extremely hard, you know, to get more athletic, to get bigger and stronger, and to get more skilled. And I'm proud to say that he did it. And as a leader, he certainly is also willing to have hard conversations when he needs to for the betterment of himself or his teammates. And I hope that all that sacrifice and work put in to help him make the U16 Icelandic national team and hopefully make it again this upcoming break for the U18 team. I've done captain votes every year when all our seniors graduate that are captains, where we gotta restock on captains. And in 10 years, Berger Irving is the only one that got a vote from every one of his teammates. And that goes a long way to say what kind of leader he is. But I want to tell a little story quickly about what kind of human he is, because a lot of people don't know this, and I don't really think Berger really realizes that I recognize this. As a footnote to this story, I hate airports. big time, and I happen to be in a lot of them with these guys. And Pearson International Airport in Toronto is the worst of the worst when it comes to airports. Berger chose this year to be my co-captain or my co-pilot in my van. And last October of this past, we were in Toronto, our first trip. We made so many mistakes at 5:30 in the morning trying to get to the airport that my stress level was just already through the roof before we got there. We arrived at Terminal 3. We're supposed to leave from Terminal 1. I have no idea where I'm supposed to go, but Berger very calmly just says, "I got it, coach. It's good. Just follow me." And he travels a lot, so I did. And we go through the airport, and we get to the tickets, and I'm already thinking we're going to miss the flight. The flight's gone. We're not getting home. There's no way we're getting home. We go through the tickets, and Toronto has taken on this new thing at Pearson Airport where they don't believe in human beings anymore. Everything's a robot, so you got to just do it all yourself, put the bags away. And just so happened, Berger and I were the last two out. So the team's going through security, and we're walking through security. I get a tap on my shoulder from Berger, and he says, "Coach, one second." And I'm like, "One second? Like, we don't have a second. The flight's going to leave." He's like, "One second." Berger proceeds to walk over. He had noticed the family. And the family, you can tell the family could speak English. But you could also tell from that father's face, their flight was leaving much sooner than our flight. Berger just took charge. Got their passports, did the tickets, got their bags tagged, showed them where the conveyor belt was for the bag, showed to help all the family carry all the luggage, but then went above and beyond, actually found a human being that was there, an attendant, and made sure that he was leaving, made sure that they saw the ticket, because he wanted to make sure they got on the plane. Walked over to me, just calmly says, "All right, we're good now." Wasn't for acknowledgement, it was just the right thing to do. That's the guy that gets everybody's vote. So Berger, I love you. And I want to welcome you to the Basketball Alumni family. Next senior goes by the name of David Mean Muggin Alugo. Now, similar to Berger, who's the Iceman, because he's from Iceland, there is not a magical inside funny joke I have for David's name. I really honestly thought for the first few months of knowing him that he did not like me at all. And he's so serious, so calculated all the time. But David is as close to a four-year senior as we have. David Alugo joined midway through grade 9, and it was tough. That year we had a lot of seniors. And we had a lot to what you would call as close to grown men as you could possibly imagine. David was one of the smaller players. David was one of the most unathletic players we had. And he was probably one of the most lesser skilled players. And there was moments in that half year that David Alugo had every reason to quit. And David, I know you remember that particular conversation over there in that corner, where once again, I knew David was calculated. That's who David is. He's not going to ever do something for the sake of doing it. If he's doing it, he's going to get better at it. He's going to try to become the best at it. And he made a choice because he knew I was the same way. There's no halfway. You're either all in or you're all out. I'm either going to get on you until you break and decide that that's what you want, or you're going to decide that it's not what you want. That's okay too. David completely transformed himself in one offseason. Now, David Alugo on our team is one of the biggest, if not the biggest and strongest pound-for-pound player we have. Every now and then, I'll suit up and play against the guys, and if I get hit by a screen by David, or if he boxes me out, I swear to God, I feel it for about 4 weeks. David, in our testing, is regularly the most athletic player we have in most of our testing. And skillfully, I'll say with absolute confidence that if we need him to at any point because of foul trouble, injuries, or whatever the reason might be, he can easily play 1-5 offensively or guard 1-5 defensively. And that was a calculated choice. So David, for your investment in yourself, more importantly, in the program, I love you, and I want to welcome the basketball one. class senior goes by the name of Farrell, the floor general nation. When I was recruiting Farrell, it was on that beautiful, during that beautiful time called COVID, and it was over a Zoom call. And at that particular time, our assistant coach at the time, Cleve Henry, and I were making up some questions. We wanted to evaluate how Farrell fit into our game as a program. We kind of knew we had needs that he had as skills, but I was more concerned about culture. All right, I'm very much big on culture. And I was concerned, I'm always concerned with recruiting guys from Toronto that they're going to look down upon East Coast basketball. They're going to look down on our East Coast culture. I quickly realized in the first 45 seconds of that conversation, Farrell had done his homework. And that turned into Farrell interviewing me, and less so about Farrell interviewing, or me interviewing Farrell. He knew names of guys that were on our team that weren't necessarily the front name guys that went on to other programs. He knew how I coached because he watched so many games and evaluated how I would pick guys up and how I would talk to guys. He always talked about culturally it being a good fit for him at this school. But Farrell, you also know that if I stood here with Mike and said from grade 10 to grade 12 was nothing but smooth sailing, I'd be lying because there was ups and downs. But anyone in the crowd that's married, anyone in the crowd that has kids, anyone in the crowd that has a relationship that they actually care about, you know that those moments are when the relationship is its strongest, not its weakest. Because it's not a matter of you quitting. It's just a matter of getting through it and learning a little bit more about that person so that relationship actually becomes strong. Nothing gives me more pride than a teacher, a staff member, random parent, random student I might not teach or coach, coming up to me, making a point to come up to me and tell me about one of my players and how that player improved their day, had a positive conversation with them, did something to make themselves better or the campus better, or help somebody in some way. I cannot count the amount of times this year a staff member or someone like that came up to me and told me a positive thing about Farrell Nation. And aside from having arguably the best name I've ever heard in my life, Farrell, you're an amazing guy and you contributed so much to this culture. I love you and I want to welcome the basketball alumni family. And now time for a basketball game. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, Yes! Yeah. Thank you. Stop. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
back. Shoot, buddy.
Well, that's all right. Sit it on the seat. CPL is good. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, for sure. For sure. We'll be happy. Marquito.
Yes, sir.
You guys see on the picture, bro. For sure, man.
That's like, bro.
But yeah.
I'll see you after break.
Yeah, man. Like, so that's when you lost the confidence in the world, man. Because it was like, it's like, the thing is, the first year where you go to like a full court and a full size rig.